everyone. This is Gail. I am sorry I have been out of the loop here lately. I have really been busy. I'm trying to get my Fun Stampers Journey business going. I'm creating a blog, which goodness knows when I'll have time to work on that. But there's just so much going on, and I just haven't had time to do another video. And so I promise I'm going to get that going pretty quickly. I think I've got just about all of my time-consuming things taken care of. But I wanted to give you an update on my book, Destash. Thank you very much for those that have purchased books. I appreciate it so much. One of you, it looks like, may have in your envelope my master list of my books and who bought what. So if you happen to get that in your envelope, please just throw it away. But if you have a scanner, I would appreciate it if you would scan it and email me a copy to loveToClay, LUV2Clay@gmail.com. Because I have looked everywhere for my, I've got another sheet that I have, but not the one that I listed who bought what. So I'm kind of at a loss right now. So anyway, I wanted to show you what I have left, and I also told you I had a few other books that I didn't have, I hadn't looked up yet. I'm trying something different with my light. It's afternoon, and I get afternoon sun in the one window that I have in this room. So I turned off my overhead light that lights up my work surface, and I'm hoping you can see this, that the light, the other light that I have is bright enough that you can see. It looks like it on my screen, but I've noticed that what my screen shows me and what you see are sometimes different things. But I told you I had a couple of more books, and there's four books that I have found that are going to be part of the Destash, and I'll tell you about them. And since I use numbers on the others, I'm going to use letters on these. So this is book A. And it's Polymer Clay Surface Designs, and it's by Ellen Marshall. And you can see some of the things that she does. It says 100 Mixed Media Techniques Plus Project Ideas. And she has got, you know, lots of fun projects in here. I know you can't see much just by my flipping through, but a lot of surface design. If you like applying things to the surfaces, this is just fantastic. This is going to be book A, and it's $10. Book B is Creative Canes, 30 plus cane techniques with polymer clay, and it's by Barbara McGuire. And again, you can see the fun things that she has in the book. She's got a face cane. Show you how to do a face cane. That might be something I need to do. It's just going to make it a very long video, but I'll work that out. But here are just some of the things. And this is book B, and it is going to sell for $10. Now, book C is called Polymer Clay, Exploring New Techniques and New Materials, featuring a special section on precious metal clay. And there's the front of this book. I still have a little bit of glare from my other light, but I'm trying to keep that at a minimum. And again, this chrysanthemum cane will show up in this book. It shows up in so many of the books because that at one time was a real popular technique. But this is by Georgia Sargent and Salifago with Livia McRae, or McRee, I'm not sure. But the, let's see, where does the silver precious metal clay start? Somewhere back here. Exploring Precious Metal Clay. Okay, that starts on page 75. So you've got a nice long section here on metal clay, if you're interested in that, and then you go to her gallery. So she's probably got 30 pages on exploring precious metal clay. And then there's the other projects that are in here that are polymer clay. And I love this technique. This one here. I just think, let me get that light so it's not quite so bright. See what I can do to get there. How's that? Is that too dark? But I love this technique. I just think this is fantastic. It's a Mogume Gane, and it's just beautiful. I love it. And the black and the gold, I just think it's awesome. I think there's even some silver in there. It's black and gold and silver. So that might be a color combination I might try. And again, did you notice it when I flipped through? There's the chrysanthemum cane. Like I said, this shows up in so many of these books. Book C, and that sells for $5. And the last one that you haven't seen before is Quick and Easy Gifts in Polymer Clay. This is by Lisa Pavelka, and it includes 25 projects. And it's, of course, everything Lisa does is first class, but there's just so much in here. And like I said, I refer to these books often, but I've really gotten to the point that I'm looking so much up on YouTube that I sometimes don't bring the books out. But this is a fantastic book. It is book D, and it sells for $10. Now, those are the ones that I had not shown you before. These are all that I have left from the batch that I showed you last week. And these are the ones that are still available. This is the Weekend Crafter Polymer Clay. This is book number 2. It's by Irene Dean. Sells for $10. And I'll thumb through that a little bit just so you can get an idea of some of the projects that are in this book. I'm not going to stop and talk about any just because it's not fair, but there's some really nice projects in here. But this is number 2, sells for $10. Let me put those over here on my table. Book number 6 is Polymer Clay Extravaganza, and again, this is Lisa Pavelka, and it sells for $10. Let me just show you the front there. Isn't that pretty? And it doesn't, oh, here it is, 21 projects, including memory crafts, paper crafts, home decor, and more. But it's all, you know, just look at that. These are, I guess it's part of her gallery at the back. But then she starts in the projects, and there's a garden angel, garden stakes, to show you that you can use polymer clay outside. There's all kinds of jewelry. Just a number of things in here. A pen holder. What is that? A gilded frame. Just so much. But this is book number 6, $10. Then I have book number 7, which is also $10. This is Polymer Clay Techniques book by Sue Heaser. And it says, over 50 techniques for creating fabulous oven clay projects from jewelry to dollhouse miniatures. And you can just see the things that are on the front here. Alf. This is miniature food. She's got the miniatures in the back. She's got all kinds of miniatures. Then she has jewelry, faux stones of different types, metallic powders, stamping, using armatures, making face, you know, using armatures for face canes. Just different effects that are in here. This is an excellent book. This is book number 7, and it sells for $10. Then book number 8 is Create a Polymer Clay Impression. And this is Sarah Jane Helm. It's $5. This is her gallery in the back. Look at that guitar. Can you believe that? Look at that guitar. It's all covered in clay. There's some more over here. Aren't they awesome? But then, you know, there's lots of projects here. She shows a little bit of quilting, some art deco, some oriental, antique ivory, Victorian roses, just lots of different things in here. But this is Creative Polymer Clay Impression, book number 8. It's $5. And then this one, I'm so surprised that nobody picked this up. This is like the book to have for polymer clay. And this is Nan Roche, The New Clay. And this is one of the first books that ever came out about polymer clay, back when polymer clay was brand new. And there's so much in here, and it says techniques and approaches to jewelry making. She did mainly jewelry. Book number 9, this is $10. And let me just show you some of the things that are in here. I'm not gonna comment on each individual thing, but you can see it's mostly jewelry. There's a few other things in here, but it's a fantastic book. I almost didn't sell this just because it's almost a collector's item. But this is a fantastic book, The New Clay by Nan Roche, number 9, $10. And then number 10 is Fast Polymer Clay, Speedy Techniques and Projects for Crafters in a Hurry by Sue Heaser. And again, this is another fantastic book, but it's not, like I said, I went on to Amazon and found all of these books and what they were selling for on Amazon, and then I cut the price from that. So I forgot what this sold for on Amazon, but I went ahead and cut the price to $3. But she's got some, I mean, they're quick and easy. She's got some templates in the back. There's an owl jumping jack. I remember that now. Just different templates that you can use for the projects that she has in this book. Little figures. Picture frames. Tableware. Desk accessories. She's got toys, games, dollhouse accessories. So she does a lot of miniatures. There's jewelry, buttons, just all kinds of things, as well as just some good general instructions on different simple canes. So this is book number 10, and it's $3. Here's the little small book, Press a Posy. And these are using the Amoco molds. If you have some Amoco molds, which I do, and I may include I can't do it for $3. If you're interested, I have some Amoco molds, and if you want to wait just a second, I'll find out which ones I've got. Okay, I do have 3 Amoco molds, and they're hard molds. I probably should clean them up for you if I sell them, but these are the push molds. Some of these are used in this book. This one is Hearts and Swirls, if you can see that. This one is Poinsettias and Holly. So there's that. And this one is Violets and Ivy. So those are really cute. But if you want, I don't know that I can look and see what's in here. The book alone is book number 12, and it sells for $3. Let me see. This is, all right, this uses, it uses the rose mold, but I don't have rose. But I do have the ivy and the violets and ivy, which is part of that one. Pansies. I thought I had a pansy mold, unless I just didn't see it. This one uses the poinsettias and holly mold. A holiday bath set, but you can use this on anything. And that may, well, this pin here uses the hearts and swirls, but it also uses the roses, which I do not have. And this one is, I don't have, well, this one does use the violets and ivy, but it does, I don't have the others that go with it. But anyway, if you would like this book, the book alone is book number 12, and it's $3. It says 22 projects made with flower push molds. Another quick edit. I did find another Amoco pansy mold. So now there's four molds, so I'm going to have to change my prices on that. The book is still $3. The molds by themselves would be $10. And the molds with the book would be $12. So this is book number 12. It's the Presupposy. It's going to be $3 by itself. Four molds would be $10. And with the book with the molds will be $12. Okay, then we have book number 13. And this is Images on Clay. And I do believe there, because I have another one. I have Images on Clay, and this is Nan Roche, Gwen Gibson, Dale DeRosho, and Barbara McGuire. Those are four names that are synonymous with polymer clay. This is book number 13, and it's $8. And it also techniques, what is this for? Special techniques, cutout image book, transfer color, copy or images with special printer, transfer paper, or liquid polymer. Okay, so there's some transfer, there's some petrograph collage. There's Makume Gane again, glazing, markers and overlays, coloring transfers. There's another transfers on clay, transfers on clay, translucent and gold leaf layering, stamping on clay, different methods. Okay, so that's it. Images on Clay. And this is book number 13, and it's $8. Now, this one had been claimed by someone, but they never contacted me, never sent me any contact information, never replied to any of my emails. So I am putting this back on the active list. This is Images on Clay 2, and this is all by Barbara McGuire. And this is number 14. And it's $7. And she talks about transferring in images, portrait pins. That's what these are up here. Modern made Picasso doll. That's kind of cute. And a modern made Mona Lisa doll. It's got a Mona Lisa face on it. Triangle ornament, could be a pendant or an ornament. A map panel here where you would transfer a map. Border and pedestal pendants. There's a pendant. Oh, pendant, not pendant. Pennants. There's the pendant, and there's a close-up of the just the cabochon. Green diamond ribbon journals. Ancient image beads. These again are some templates that you can use, that you can photocopy and use. There's got some of the ancient images here if you want to use that. Here's some more little small ones. So she provides these with directions, and then here's this. This was in one of the this face was in one of the other books. There's the Mona Lisa in two sizes, but she tells you to have it, take it to your copy shop. Oh, look at these. These are nice. Flowers. To photocopy them on a toner-based copier. And then these are called macaroni beads, but they're not made out of macaroni. They're made out of polymer clay. But you remember when you were a kid, you made macaroni beads? Or at least I did. Half-cylinder beads, where it's round on the top, but it's flat on the inside, like it's just a half cylinder. And on each of these pages, you'll see little, I don't know if you can see them or not, little templates that you can use, you can copy to put on your clay. Transferred panel holder, that's this. She made a holder for a candle. Transfer portrait painting, this is a standalone thing that is in here. Basic Makume Gane stacks, and then she does Makume transfer bracelets. Banded and capped beads, mixing color, a color necklace. I made one of these where I took the clay and I started with one color and I started blending all the way around the color wheel, and I've still got the bead somewhere. And another translucent panel. But this is a really nice book. This is Images on Clay 2, number 14, and it's $7. Now, stamping with polymer clay and wire is a whole list of people that contributed to this. It's 35 pages long. I've got it priced at $3. It's book number 15, and it's different ways of stamping, different methods of stamping on polymer clay, and some of the things you can do with it. Making miniature flowers with polymer clay. I'm surprised this one didn't get grabbed. Actually, it did. This was also the person that never contacted me after they claimed these. But it says, a step-by-step guide to crafting roses, daffodils, irises, pansies, and more. And you can see the roses there, and there's the pansies. And this is a nice thick book. It is 128 pages, but you not only learn how to make the, like look at that little iris. That is really pretty. There's the irises. This is the daffodil. But she also has some little templates here on how you can configure your pansies. These are pansies. Cherry blossom, just lots of different flowers. Daisies, dogwood, just lots of flowers. So if you're a flower maker, this is a great book. This is book number 19 and it's $10. And then this is the third book that was claimed and never contacted me. Creative Stamping in Polymer Clay. It's 24 unique projects. This is also Barbara McGuire. Can you tell she was really big in polymer clay and that I really liked her? Because I can't tell you how many of these books are by Barbara McGuire. Book number 20. It's $5. And it's not that it's a cheap book, because it's not. But I just tried to, I'm trying to find 123. So there's about 130 pages of this, but Barbara is, she's just fantastic. There's a spirit doll in here, a textured collage frame, a butterfly ghost patterns, which is Makume Gane, or a mica shift. Bits and pieces bracelet, she calls this. Cylinder beads, covering, how to cover the handles of your tools, a wooden tassel holder, some jewelry. There's just lots in here. This is book number 20, and it's $5. And then last but not least, I know you're tired of hearing about these, Polymer Clay Creations, 11 easy projects you can make. And this is Marie Siegel, who's another polymer clay icon. And it's just lots of different things in here. There's a gold frame, designer jewelry, East meets West. It's sort of a faux jade, I guess, using embossing powders, I assume. There's a handle, a knob for a drawer. This is a memory book. But not only are you learning the projects, but you're it's not just like a memory book. In order to make the memory book, you've got to learn how to do all the stuff that goes on the memory book. So this is some of the projects here. Again, this is $8. It's book number 26. And that is it. I think my next Destash is probably going to be my Polymer Cafe magazines, if any of you are interested. If you want some of these the books that I just had, but you also might want some of the Polymer Clay magazines, I don't mind holding your order until I get the rest of the Polymer Cafe magazines done. I go all the way back to the very beginning when it first started, but I stopped getting them maybe 5 or 6 years ago. But I've got them almost every issue from the very first all the way up to maybe 2009, 2010, somewhere in that area. So I will be putting those up very shortly, as soon as I get them together and can figure out what I want to charge for them. And I want to get them in order so that it'll be easier to list. So anyway, I hope you have had a wonderful day. I know I have. And I will see you soon with a polymer clay project, I promise. See you later. Bye-bye.